welcome to my channel, Genealogy Central. Today, we will be looking at the British royal family, from William the Conqueror to Elizabeth II. We will start off at William the Conqueror. He conquered England in 1066 after he killed Harold Godwinson at the Battle of Hastings. Upon his death in 1087, his son, William II, became king. 13 years later, he died in a hunting accident that was definitely an accident, and no one would say otherwise. The crown then went to Henry I. Matilda would have become queen if it wasn't for a civil war where Stephen of Blois, grandson of William I, through his mother Adela, beats her and becomes king. Stephen had no children, so the crown goes to Matilda's son, Henry. Henry II became the first Plantagenet and in 1169 became Lord of Ireland. When he died, the crown went to Richard, who tried to conquer the Holy Land but failed miserably. These were called the Crusades. Next came John I, who signed Magna Carta, then died after a reign of taxing everyone ludicrous amounts. After an unusually long reign from Henry III and 1-2-3 Edwards later, we have the Wars of the Roses, our second civil war. His grandson, Richard II, took over when he died. Richard II was killed in 1400, being taken over by Henry IV. Him, his son and his grandson, all named Henry, ruled until Edward IV, third cousin of Henry VI. Through his dad, Richard, and his dad, also named Richard, son of Edmund, connecting to the family by Edmund's dad, Edward III. Anyway, back to Edward IV. His son, Edward V, took over. Then his uncle, Richard III, took over. Unlike the myth, he did not kill his nephews. Then Henry VII beat Richard III, ending the war. He was related to Edward III by John of Gaunt, to John, to Margaret, to Henry VII. Henry VII married Elizabeth of York, and his son, Henry VIII, took over. He famously had 6 wives. When Henry died of gout in 1547, his son Edward VI took over. Upon his death, the crown should have gone to his eldest sister, Mary, but instead went to his first cousin once removed, Lady Jane Grey, who shockingly ruled for 9 days. Her royal status is debated. When Lady Jane Grey was executed, the crown went to Mary of England, not Scotland. Mary married Philip II of Spain, who had the intention of marrying her so he would become King of England. When Mary I died, the crown would have gone to him, but we did not like him, so Elizabeth became queen. When she died in 1603, where would the crown go? The answer, James VI of Scotland. James, the great-grandson of Margaret Tudor, was next in line to the throne. Margaret's son, James V of Scotland, had Mary of Scots. She was James's mother. James married Anne of Denmark, and they had Charles I. He was king until another civil war. Oliver Cromwell beat Charles I and got the title Lord Protector. Oliver was very miserable. When he died, Oliver's son should have ruled, but it went to Charles II, Charles I's son. Charles II had no kids, so the crown went to James II, then to Will III and Mary II, spouses and cousins. They had no children, so it went to Anne I. Anne had no children, despite being pregnant 17 times. With none of Charles I's descendants having any children, where would the crown go? George of Hanover. His mother, Sophia of Hanover, was the daughter of Elizabeth Stuart, who was the other Charles of James I. George I did not speak English, so accidentally made prime ministers. The crown then went to George II, to George III. He went mad from a genetic disease. This also made him have purple wee. George IV then took over. William IV, George's brother, became king next. Then William's niece, Victoria, became queen. And then it was Edward VII to George V, who reigned during World War I, to his son Edward VIII in 1936. He abdicated so he could be with Wallis Simpson. Edward's brother, George VI, took over and oversaw World War II. Then his daughter, Elizabeth, started her reign in 1952. Elizabeth II is Britain's current queen and is the longest reigning monarch in world history. Thank you for watching, and remember, like and subscribe!